Many times, the easiest way to improve a map is to change its base map. Hi, I'm Heather and I'm a cartographer. In this video, I'll show you a few tricks for modifying base maps. In ArcGIS Online, at the top of the base map pane, click the current base map button. This takes you to the base map layers pane. Base maps can have multiple layers and you can control them all separately. And this is the secret to controlling your base map. Here are a few of my favorite techniques. Number one, turn off the labels. Does your map need labels? In this case, I think my target audience doesn't need to see the labels, and they're hiding my thematic data in a few places, making both the data and the labels harder to read. I could move the label layer out of the reference group and into the base group. Anything in the base group will draw below the thematic data, and anything in the reference group will draw on top. It's like a base map sandwich. Alternatively, I could simply turn the labels off. I'll click the visibility button and they disappear. I can even remove this layer entirely if I want. Number two, add a hill shade. With this add button, I can add any layer I want to a base map, provided it's a tile layer. My favorite tile layer is in Living Atlas and it's called World Hillshade. It's used in a lot of other base maps, but not this one. So I'll add it and click the back button. And now the World Hillshade layer is part of my base map. Unfortunately, it's hiding everything underneath of it, so on the Properties pane, I'll set the Blend Mode to Multiply. That allows me to see the hillshade layer and everything under the hillshade layer at the same time. Number three, desaturate the base map. So let's go back to the main base map pane. For this map, I've decided that I need to see more detail in the land cover, so I'll switch to the imagery base map. But the imagery base map is so bright and colorful, it's really competing visually with the red symbols. Also, red symbols on a green background is not colorblind friendly. Instead of changing the symbols, I'll try to change the base map. I'll go back into the base map layers pane, select the imagery layer, and open the effects pane. Here, I'm going to turn on the saturate effect and bring it way down so the map is almost black and white. And I can take this further, I'll also turn on the brightness and contrast effect and use it to make the base map super dark. The imagery base map, once it's desaturated, no longer competes so much with the thematic data. So if you can't find the perfect base map for your needs, try modifying one. You can reorder, add, and remove layers from a base map. You can also change the appearance of any base map layer using blend modes and effects.